بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. سبحانك لا علم لنا الا ما علمتنا انك انت العليم الحكيم. الحمد لله الذي ابدع الافلاك والاردين، والصلاه والسلام على من كان نبيا وادم بين الماء والطين، وعلى اله وصحابه اجمعين. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وقال لهم نبيهم إن آية ملكه أن يأتيكم التابوت فيه سكينة من ربكم وبقية مما ترك آل موسى وآل هارون تحمله الملائكة، إن في ذلك لآية لكم إن كنتم مؤمنين. صدق الله مولانا العظيم، وبلغنا رسوله النبي الأمين المتين الكريم، ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. قال الله عز وجل في شأن حبيبه الكريم مخبرا وآمرا قولا كريما: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا شفيعنا نبينا مولانا محمد، طب القلوب ودوائها وعافة الأبدان وشفائها ونور الأبصار وضيائها، وعلى آله وصحبه دائما أبدا. Honorable علماء، حفاظ، my respected elders, dear brothers, mothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. After praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending salutations upon the best of creation, the jewel of creation, the cream of creation, our intercessor on the day of judgment, Ahmed Mustafa, Muhammad Mustafa, Arwah Nafidah, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, and upon his blessed family members and all his companions, I would like to take this opportunity to thank Almighty Allah for granting this blessed Jum'at al-Mubarakah with good health and with good atmosphere. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our hazri here inshaAllah, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our previous sins, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfill our lawful desires. Alhamdulillah, today the topic what I have chosen is the blissful heavenly box of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Holy Quran, Allah says, and their prophet said to them, the sign of his kingdom is that there would come to you a wooden box in which from your Lord is the contentment of hearts and containing some relics left behind the honorable Musa and the honorable Harun alayhi salatu wassalam, carried by the angels. Indeed, it is a great sign for you if you are believers. This is the verse of the Holy Quran, and this verse is from Surah Al-Baqarah. This is from the Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says beautifully regarding the wooden box of a Bani Israel. This mention, Tabut Sakina, the full of mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this box, it is mentioned in Hadith al-Barakah and under the tafsir of this verse, that this box made of box falsehood that was revealed to Sayyiduna Adam alayhi salatu wassalam from the Jannah. This wooden box revealed both Sayyiduna Adam alayhi salatu wassalam from Jannah. And this box remained with him until the last day of his worldly life. Later on, it was passed on to his children one after the other as inheritance. This box reached to Nabi Sayyiduna Yaqub alayhi salatu wassalam. And it remained under the custody of his progeny. And the Bani Israel, later it reached to Sayyiduna Musa alayhi salatu wassalam. So Sayyiduna Yaqub alayhi salatu wassalam carried on Bani Israel this box till this box reached to Nabi Musa alayhi salatu wassalam. And he alayhi salatu wassalam, Nabi Musa alayhi salatu wassalam, he used to keep his clothes, okay, and the Torah, whatever his belongings, his possession, he used to keep it in that box. And this box was extremely holy box. Whenever the Bani Israel would do jihad against the pagans, and whenever they would get worried due to the number of enemies being large, they would place the box in front of them. Blessings would emanate from it, and that would solace their worried hearts. And when this box would be carried ahead, the glad tidings of Nasrun min Allah wa Fathun Qareeb would be bestowed from the sky, and they would become victorious in every battle. So they used to carry that box in front of them. They used to place in front of them. They used to make dua in the court of Allah through the box, this wooden box. This box is not Nabi. Understand? This box is not Prophet. This box is not a wali. This box is sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the Jannah with Nabi Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. So this box, this wooden box, has nisbat with Nabi Adam alayhi salatu wasalam and all his children, other prophets, till Nabi Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam. This box has nisbat with Nabi Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam, Nabi Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, and the other great prophets and great bondsmen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Are you with me? Are you listening? Yes. If you're listening, I know you're wearing mask, but still you can say subhanallah. You were not worried about COVID. Now it's Omicron, it's light. If Allah wants to give you something, you think this mask will prevent? Do you think this mask will stop? Then have full tawakkul in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Last day before last night, a friend of mine, Durban, informed me. He said, we all went for holidays and his wife got COVID and it was itself, all his sister, brother, everybody. But husband said, I still my wife, but I never get positive. I went for test, came negative. If Allah wants to save everybody, no one can harm. But I want you to say subhanallah, mashallah. Don't look at me like I'm a burger or something, KFC, nice, single burger or something. And you're waiting for bismillah. So you just smile and say subhanallah, mashallah. Although which is halal is halal, okay? I'm not saying KFC is halal or haram or something. I'm not passing any comment. If KFC got halal certificate and properly, it's anything, but whichever is halal, okay? You must check. But before you check halal, you must check your money also must be halal. money must be halal also. If money is halal and you're looking for halal food shop, there's no use. Huh? So they used to place the wooden box, they used to make dua. Listen carefully, because this everything is aqidah. And nowadays, aqidah is important. Sahaba Ridwanullah used to say, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to feel shy to read namaz next to munafiqun. Hame sharm aati hai unke paas namaz padhne mein, kyunki unke ruku humse lambe hote hain, unke sajde humse lambe hote hain, unki namazein humse lambi hoti hain. They extend the ruku more than us. They make namaz long ruku and long sajda, Ya Rasulullah. We feel shy to read namaz next to them. But these kind of people were chased out of Masjid al-Nabawi Sharif by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is the mercy to the entire universe. To understand, namaz is not important. Important, but first is aqidah important. If aqidah is not important, you can read like shaitan how many times sajda and namaz, your namaz will be thrown on your face. Your aqidah is right, then your namaz is accepted. Your aqidah is right, then your roza is accepted. Your aqidah is right, how you think about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what you think about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how you love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sahaba, then your aqidah is right. Not you love Rasulullah, how nothing you used to respect. No. Then your namaz is wasting your time. Wasting your time by saying Abdullah and Abdul Qadir and Musa and Baqir. There's no use. Rather, you must check your imam. So imam, that's what I'm saying. This aqidah from Quran and mentioned. This box they used to place in front of them. They used to make dua and they used to be victorious in every battle. Bani Israel used to be victorious in every battle, in whatever they used to go, and they used to carry this box. This box, through this box, they used to make dua. And no prophet said, why are you making dua in the word of Allah? Why do you need the wasila of this box? This box is not even prophet. Huh? This box is not even salah, this box is not even the box, this is a heavenly box, but this box people used to keep, Anbiya Ikram used to keep by them, their possessions, their belongings in that box, like a safe box. Now that box became a holy box, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Holy Quran. Anyway, whenever there was another thing, whenever there was any difference of opinion among the Bani Israel, they would seek advice from the box. They used to place and say, oh box, we got this difference of opinion amongst ourselves. What do you say? That box used to say, follow this, follow that. They used to follow. Subhanallah. And when you said they used to hear the glad tidings, the victory would be heard from the blissful box. The Bani Israel used to keep this box with them during their supplications. By virtue of which supplications would accept and due to its blessings. The applications and calamities would be averted. In short, the blissful box was a source of great blessings and a treasure of bounties for the Bani Israel. This box. However, this is the name that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them. Like as I mentioned, the meaning of the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them, but it's right to them. And whenever when you have the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ni'mat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and if you don't look after that ni'mat of Allah, that bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you disrespect, if you don't the value that ni'mat of Allah, whatever Allah gave you, when the ni'mat of beauty, ni'mat of wealth, ni'mat of knowledge, ni'mat of whatever, whatever Allah gave you, if you don't look after that ni'mat will be taken. And the same thing happened to Bani Israel. When Bani Israel, their sins, their sinful deeds exceeded all the limits, the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala struck them. The people of Amalika, the people of Amalika attacked the Bani Israel, and a massive bloodshed took place. Many of the Bani Israel were killed, their homes were ruined, and the cities was destroyed. The Amalika tribe also took the sacred box with them, and disrespectfully they threw that box into a garbage. However, when the people of the Amalika disrespected this holy box, Tabut al-Sakina holy box, what happened? Wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala attacked them. And the people of Amalika were completely destroyed. The pagans realized that the destruction was due to their misconduct and disrespect towards the sacred box. Therefore, they loaded the box on a cart dragged by bulls and drove it towards the towards the town of the Banu Israel, and they sent it back, this holy box. They realized that even because of this disrespect of this holy box, not a disrespect of Wali of Allah, not the disrespect of the Abiyah of Allah, you understand what I'm saying? The only the disrespect of the box, holy box, which is revealed. And in that box, what was in that box? Later I will tell you, inshallah, the part of this now. So they realized, the enemies realized, the enemies of Bani Israel realized. But you see, one side, the Bani Israel exceeded their sinful deeds. That's how azab of Allah came. Whenever in society and community, whenever the sin or the wrong activities, the evil activities takes place, and if we all of us keep quiet, remain silent, and we keep quiet and we don't correct, and you say, no, this is not my business, this is not our business. You know, everybody says, it's not our business. It is your business. If this is not your business, then wait for the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and azab of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and azab of Allah will catch you. Then you will not have time to save yourself. If anyone you see, if anyone is indulged in committing sin, you know, you are right to say nicely and say, please don't do this, this is haram. If some of your friend, you know, sometimes people talk in front of us about so and so women, for example, so and so wrong things, and we laugh. Hey, you're nutty, yeah, rubbish, man. But we don't say, hey, don't do this, this is haram. We just laugh and we become a part of that sin. We don't correct. We say, this is not our business. Let him do whatever. No, this is your business, you have to correct him. And if you don't correct him, Azab Allah will come. And there's hadith also. And you might have heard this hadith came onto the big town where everybody was sinners. Few people were very pious people, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, what you did, they were pious for themselves. They never corrected others. And there's no use of, if you are only pious, there's no use of your piety. There's no use of your taqwa until you correct others. And when you correct others, it feels bad or good, whatever, as long as you please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then alhamdulillah, you are protected from the adab of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't say, no, somebody else's son is not yours. No, must tell nicely. So tell nicely, nobody will feel bad. If they feel bad and they swear, you take that swear, no problem. Say, no problem, I did only for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as long as you did your job. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you. So anyways, other side, the Amalika, people of Amalika, they insulted the holy box, azab of Allah came upon them. And they sent box. Okay. Now what happened? Another side, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's prophet, Nabi Shamil alayhi salatu wasalam, he made a Talut as the king of Bani Israel. So people of Bani Israel said, we're not going to accept Talut as a king. Nabi Shamil alayhi salatu wasalam said, wait, if you think I'm making a wrong person a king, then you will see if he's a right person, the box what you people lost, the box, holy box, will come to you. If people say, okay, no problem, if this holy box come back to us, then we'll accept Talut as a king. Nabi Shamil alayhi salatu wasalam, when he accepted, then that the same Amalika people of Amalika sent, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appointed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appointed an angels to carry that box. What was in that box? Listen carefully, what was in that box? Number one, the holy box contained the holy stuff and the blessed shoes of Nabi Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. What was in that box? The blessed shoes of Nabi Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. And the blessed turban of Nabi Harun alayhi salatu wasalam. According to some narration, the stick of Asa of Nabi Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. the ring of Nabi Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam, and the sacred tablets on which Torah was written. The Holy Torah was written, the sacred tablets. You can see the tablets, yeah. Takhti. Some of the manna and salwa, heavenly food, but revealed upon Palestine. That was some food, tabarruk. This is called tabarruk. People ask, what is the proof of tabarruk? This is the tabarruk was in that box. And that's how that's the whole box became a tabarruk. And the tabarruk. Nabi Musa has the shoes, the turban, and asa, and ring. These things were there in that box. And people, Bani Israel, used to make dua through the wasilah of that box. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used to grant them victory in every battle. And they used to seek advice from the holy box. Subhanallah. Are you with me? Looks like not. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, وقال لهم نبيهم إن آية ملكه أن يأتيكم التابوت فيه سكينة من ربكم وبقية مما ترك آل موسى وآل هارون تحمله الملائكة إن في ذلك لآية لكم إن كنتم مؤمنين. And the prophet said to them, the sign of his kingdom is that they would come to you a wooden box in which from your Lord is the contentment of hearts and containing some relics, remnants left behind Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam and Sayyidina Harun alayhi salatu wasalam, carried by the angels. Indeed, is a great sign for you if you are believers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Holy Quran regarding this. So dear brothers, we have learned many things from this box. I hope you learned many things and understand. The possessions and belongings of the chosen bondsmen of Allah are very prestigious in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and are means of acquiring blessings and bounties. You see, the box contained the blessed shoes and staff of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam and the blessed turban of Nabi Harun alayhi salatu wasalam and other tabarrukats. And by virtue of all these, the box was so revered that it was carried by the angels. The angels carrying the shoes of Nabi Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. The angels carrying the turban of Nabi Harun alayhi salatu wasalam, the ring of Nabi Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam. You can understand the martaba and maqam of Anbiya Ikram alayhi salatu wasalam. Their shoes were carried by the angels. And if the Nabi Musa alayhi salatu wasalam his shoe got so much maqam and status, what about the shoe of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam? What about the blessed hair of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam? What about the blessed kurta of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? And leave about all these things. What about the blessed aan of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which has a nisbat and bed of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Subhanallah. So we have to understand, whatever has nisbat with Allah's pious bondsmen, the pious awliya of Allah, the anbiya of Allah, that they also become blessings and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and tabarruk for all of us. Everything is in Quran and Hadith. We're not going to talk from our own pocket, but we have to learn, we have to understand. There are many lessons, but I think time is up. Inshallah, tabarruk wa ta'ala. We'll talk some other time. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of us tawfiq. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of us tawfiq to understand the true aqidah of Al-Sunnah wal-Jamaah. True beliefs of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep all of us on the right path. If we don't have knowledge, educate ourselves. We have to educate ourselves. But don't say this is wrong and that is wrong if you don't know everything from the Quran and Hadith and the practice of Sahaba, ridwanullahi alayhi majma'in. So this is my humble request. If you don't know anything, please come and educate and learn. Learn about the aqidah of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Otherwise, you will remain ignorant and you will raise from the day of judgment as an ignorant, as a jahil. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant our tawfiq. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.